Hola amigos, ¿qué tal? Stuart here from Spain Speaks, today coming to you from the architecturally magnificent city of Zamora. Let's go and have a look. Now I must admit that I am very impressed by what I have seen so far in this city, not just because of the architecture, but also because of the cultural aspect of this city. Absolutely fantastic. There are great monuments virtually everywhere you go in this part of the city. Of course, this is the historical part of the city, what they call here the casco antiguo, the old part of the city. And as I said, everywhere you go, there are magnificent buildings and things to see. And another one of the main attractions of this city for me is the Douro River, which I have behind me. An absolutely magnificent river, and it gives this city something extra. Now, Zamora is a city in a province with the same name, Zamora City, Zamora Province, and this city is the capital of the province. And obviously, it is the place with the biggest population in the area, around 60,000 people. And unlike another city that I was in recently in this area, Toro, the population has grown over the last 100 years. Now, one thing you will notice when you come to a city like Zamora is just how many churches there are here. In fact, I get the impression that Zamora is a very religious city. In fact, I heard somebody say yesterday in a conversation that there are more Romanesque churches in Zamora than any other city in Europe. And Zamora also has a cathedral, which is the building behind me. And like most cathedrals in this part of the world, it is an impressive building from the back, from the side, and from the front. Now, I could be wrong, but I think that Zamora is the biggest city here in Spain on this river. There are other big cities, of course, in this part of Spain, the autonomous community of Castilla y León, but none of them are on the Douro River. Valladolid, for example, is on a river, but it is not the Douro. I think it is the Pisuerga. So an interesting fact, and to be honest, I hadn't thought about it until now. And I think it is an interesting fact that neither of the two big cities here in Spain, Madrid or Barcelona, are on big rivers like other European big cities. For example, London's on an important river, Paris is on an important river, and other European capitals are on important rivers. But here in Spain, that is not the case. And as I said, churches everywhere you go here in Zamora. In fact, the Easter week here is a very, very important celebration. And some would say that it is on par with Easter celebrations in the south of the country. And the Easter week here in Zamora draws a lot of tourists to the city. And one of the things that I love about this type of city here in Spain is being able to walk through these ancient streets. But unfortunately, we have to put up with graffiti. And it's one thing that I can't understand, how some people don't understand the cultural value of these places. And they think that it's a good idea to tag the walls. Idiots. And if all graffiti looked like this, I wouldn't have a problem. Now, like all cities here in Spain, you've got your old part of the city, the Casco Antiguo, and you've got your new part of the city as well. I'm not going to show you much of the new part of the city because there's not really much to see there. All of the historical value of these cities is normally in the Casco Antiguo, and that's where I am at the moment. In fact, this is the place that we stayed last night, and I must say that it was very, very good. A very old apartment that has been refurbished, and I must say they've done a good job. And the location is second to none. Check this out. And it's a stone's throw from all of the things that you need to see here in Zamora. We're also quite close here to the Portuguese border. Of course, you can follow the river down to Portugal. I think it's about an hour away from here. And as I said before, Zamora is a very well-connected city to a lot of other parts of Spain, especially the major cities in Castilla y León. Easy to get to Salamanca, easy to get to Avila, easy to get to Valladolid, so easy to get to some of the major cities in this part of the world here in Spain. Now, the weather here in Zamora, fairly typical Castilian weather, long cold winters and brief hot summers. And midday temperatures here in the middle of summer can get into the mid-30s, so be prepared for that. And if you're coming here in the winter time, don't forget your coat, your scarf and your gloves. Another view of the river behind me and one of the magnificent bridges that crosses it. Another example of a Romanesque church behind me, one of the many in this city. Now, the province of Zamora is one of these areas in Spain which is suffering depopulation at the moment. They call it España Vaciada, empty Spain. There's a platform set up to try to reinvigorate the area, but unfortunately it's proving not to be an easy task because many, many people are moving out of rural areas and into cities like this one or down to bigger cities like Madrid. And there's a big push on to try to repopulate some of these areas here in Spain that are emptying very, very quickly. Now, on my way to the Plaza Mayor, as we know here in Spain, Spain. All roads lead to the Plaza Mayor in cities here, and Zamora is no different. In fact, Zamora is a very accessible city by foot. Don't need a car. But one thing that I will say is that I haven't seen too many people riding bicycles around their city. There doesn't seem to be a bike scheme set up similar to other cities here in Spain, and that's a shame, because even though it's not the flattest city that I've seen here in Spain, I don't think you have trouble getting around it on a bicycle or one of these e-bikes that are quite popular nowadays. One of the many squares here in Zamora, or plazas as they are known here in Spain, this one is called Viriato, and a great place to sit down and have a drink on a hot afternoon. And if you've got the money, you can stay in the Parador. Paradors here in Spain are always a good accommodation choice, but unfortunately, it's a little bit out of my price range.
Now I'll just interrupt the video here to talk about and thank the sponsor of today's video, NordVPN. If you're not familiar with a VPN, it stands for Virtual Private Network, and it will protect your internet connection and privacy online. Having a VPN means that you can use the internet safely because your data is encrypted and your online identity protected because your IP address is hidden. So, if you often connect to public Wi-Fi, like I do when I'm traveling around Spain, a VPN is an absolute must. I also use a VPN when I'm browsing at home because I can use the internet anonymously and my browsing history, usernames, passwords and bank details are kept secure. Another reason I use NordVPN is to watch content on sites that might be geo-blocked here in Spain. For example, you can access Netflix USA, Netflix Australia, BBC iPlayer and many more. You just connect to a server in the country where you want to access the content and away you go. You can use NordVPN on up to 6 devices, so you can have it on your phone, your tablet, your desktop or your laptop computer all at the same time, and it works on both Apple and Android devices. Now if you want to check out NordVPN for yourself, go to the description box in the section below and click the link or use the special code to get a 2-year plan plus 4 additional months free with a huge discount. So click the link below, take advantage of this special offer and start your safe internet experience with NordVPN. Now back to the video.
Now I'm filming this video bright and early today in order to avoid crowds, because here in Spain a lot of people are still wearing masks, and obviously I don't want to record the video with a mask on, so I'm trying to avoid people. And as you can see, streets are fairly empty at this time of the day. Now here we are in Zamora's Plaza Mayor, and surprise surprise, another Romanesque church. And this is one of the main hotspots here in Zamora when it comes to eating and drinking. Lots of restaurants to be found here. Prices are not too bad either, considering that it is the center of the city. You can pick up a menú del día here, or menu of the day, for around 12 or 13 euros, so not bad. Wash it down with a glass of local wine from the Toro region, what more do you need? But I imagine that at some times of the day, especially in spring and summer and at weekends, it's not easy to get a table at one of these establishments. Now Castilla y León and cities like Zamora have been hard hit during the COVID-19 pandemic, and unfortunately currently the pandemic is still causing problems in this part of the world. A lot of businesses here, especially ones associated to hospitality, were forced to close for a lot of months, and it hasn't been easy on that particular sector. And considering that a lot of people in places like Zamora work in the service industry, it hasn't been good for the local economy. In fact, when it comes to finding a job, not easy to do here. A lot of jobs associated to tourism, the services industry, and of course agriculture, and a lot of young people, as I said before, pack their bags and head to the bigger cities here in Spain to find a job. Because if you go to university, which is what a lot of young people do, you don't want to end up working in a bar. But as we know, that is a problem all over the country. Another church, and Zamora is also on the Camino de Santiago, the Andalusian Camino, if I'm not mistaken. So I'm sure many a pilgrim have walked these streets over the centuries. And another thing I'll say about this city is that people are very, very friendly. Everybody more than willing to tell you the best parts of the city to see, the best places to eat and drink, so no shortage of friendly, helpful people in this part of Spain. So there we go, that is my brief video about the city of Zamora. If you're planning a trip to Spain, I definitely recommend this part of the country. Plenty of things to see, plenty of things to do, food and drink second to none, and amazing architecture and historical value. As I said earlier in the video, very well connected to other parts of the country, so definitely worth a visit. On that note, I'll wrap the video up. Questions and comments, please leave them in the section below. Give the video a thumbs up if you liked it, thumbs down if you didn't. I'll see you in the next one. Hasta luego.